In this second of three videos about the Whiteboard app, we'll take a look at the tools you can use to annotate your material. Let's begin by taking a look at the hand icon on the far left of the toolbar. With this tool, you can grab the image or board to easily zoom and move it around. Note that you can use the hand tool even with the other tools selected. Next, let's take a look at the annotation tool to the right. With this, you can draw or write on top of any image or board, or even a live video. By pressing the tool again, you can select from additional options to adjust the color, size, and translucency of the line. Next, we have an additional annotation tool. It functions exactly the same as the first one. Two annotation tools let you switch between two different styles or colors as you annotate. Next up is the eraser tool. Use the eraser to selectively erase any drawings, shapes, or text you've made with the other tools. Note that the eraser only affects annotations. It doesn't alter video or the image you've imported. The next tool is the text tool. Use this tool to type and edit text wherever you like on the board. For even more annotation options, press the text tool again to access a number of shape tools, including a circle, square, line, and arrow. Each shape tool has its own adjustable color and size. Next to the text tool is the cursor tool. Use the cursor when you simply need to draw attention to certain parts of your board. Further to the right are the undo and redo tools. As the names imply, you can undo annotations if you make a mistake, or redo any annotations made by another tool. Right next to those, the clear all tool will clear all annotations by all other tools. It's the best way to create a clean slate. Last, we have the full screen tool. Press it to enter full screen mode while also clearing the tool interface for a clutter-free image. Stay tuned for our third and final video, where we will examine the different modes you can enter while in Whiteboard.